Welcome back. So in this lecture, let me create one more class which explains to Android UI Automator. UI Automator test. You can go with public static. Okay. So as usual, I will borrow the capability object rather than creating it again. So I'll take the steps. Okay. So you need to extend base class so that it inherits the properties capabilities. Add throw situation. Right. So we have seen XPath ID and all that, right? There is some more. One more thing called Android UI Automator, which is very important, just like XPath and IDs. So in this, how would you write a locator object for this Android UI Automator is a question. It's very simple. You need not have tag names as well here, in just double quotes. Okay. Give attribute equals to value. That's it. That's the only thing you need to do. But whereas in XPath we have seen you need to provide a // tag name at the rate, you have some different syntax, right? So in the UI Automator, if you want to identify an element with this Android UI Automator, okay, so what all you need to do is just provide attribute and provide a value of it. That's it. It goes and identify. Okay, let's see. Let's try to do one more example just to come out that. So as I said, this API demos is the best example to learn Appium. Okay, this app have everything to learn. The Appium guys itself has provided this app. If you are familiar with all these components, you'll be mastered in Appium. Fine, but most of things you would not require because you will not get chance to test or automate that. But I'm trying to cover everything which needed. Okay. So attribute value. So what else? Should we click on the text? Or let me click on views. Okay. So I would click on that views link. Where is my UI automator? Because without this we cannot work. Oops, stop the server. And this mistake I always make. Okay, I guess it's clean. API demos and take a screenshot. Yep, views. You see the views, and now you have all these three are common for every option, but text is unique. So in the last class, when text is unique for preferences, we tried that with XPath and we successfully clicked on it, right? And now let's click on views with the help of Android UI Automator object locator. Okay, right. So let's bring that syntax here. Oops, sorry. You need to attribute value. So this is how you need to write. I'll comment out this so that you can have some signature to analyze. So what is text here? So what attribute you want to select? So we are selecting text attribute, right? So come back. So I am saying I am selecting text attribute. Perfect. So you need to provide the value of that text attribute in these brackets. And this is nothing but views. Okay, go back and say views, right? Okay, but this value should be in double quotes. That's it. Just don't confuse with all this. So this is the basic syntax. Okay, just remember this. By seeing this, you can design your test carefully. So Android UI Automator needs an attribute and in the bracket the value of this attribute. That's it. So this is very simple. When you habituated with this Android UI Automator, you feel this more convenient than XPath. Okay, in XPath, at least you need to give this, you know, slash slash tag at the rates, everything. So here it's very simple. Attribute in brackets value. And this is now the most interview question as well. So because people, most of the people will have Selenium experience. By just going through Appium basics, they would come to interview. In Selenium, you will not have this Android UI Automator locator. Okay, so the first question they ask is, how do you deal with this? So if they can answer, we might have some basic, you know, idea on, okay, these guys worked on Appium 2. Okay, when we ask an XPath, they will definitely answer because of their experience in Selenium. But for Appium, this is unique and you won't get this in Selenium. So this was the common question asked when you go for any mobile automation interviews. Like, how do you identify an Android UI Automator and what is the syntax? And this is the syntax, attribute value. In the same way, I replicated this. But you see some errors here. Why? That's because in double quote, one more double quote is not allowed. Java does not accept double quote inside the double quote. If you want to make it accept, you need to provide one special character before that quote so that it ignores that. Okay. So when you see in any Java code, maybe Selenium, Java, or REST API automation, okay, because recently I have created one course called REST API automation, just like with Eclipse, Java, everything. So that's an awesome, which released recently by just like Selenium for web, Appium for mobile, and REST API automation for services. You can get it from my course list. You would find that. So even that, you know, these kind of objects are, you know, you will find a lot of instances. So when you see quote in quote, make sure you put with backslash. Okay. So if you remove that, you will get an error. Perfect. So with the simple syntax attribute inside value, I have done. And I would just say dot click. That's it. Now it should click on this. So the same syntax you can do in this fashion as well. With the with XPath slash slash widget text to text equals to. But I'm just giving you a lot of options, you know, I'm exposing you to all the options available in Appium to identify. Okay. So text views, click on views, and then click on animation. We'll stop it till here, okay? I just want to explain you about Android UI Automator and same thing. Animation, take a screenshot again. So first you need to get familiar with all this identifying object. Once this is clear, you know, Rust will be very easy for you. Yeah, again, text is the only unique. Okay, so there's no point again in defining that step. Let's stop it till here. Okay, again, the same, the text I need to give animation and click. I don't want to duplicate my teaching. Let's run this test and see how it identifies the element with UI Automator. Okay, so just check everything is set. Run as Java application, click on OK, come back before the script starts. You see that it clicked on views, simple, responding to client with success. And if you see that it's finding text views using Android UI Automator. See how nicely they have logged that all our logs. Okay, so debugging is, I like the Appium debugging, right? So it is saying valid locator strategies are XPath, ID, class name, Android UI Automator. So accessibility IDs for iPhones. Okay, just ignore this for now. We know, we have seen how to deal with XPath. We have seen how to deal with ID, class name. And now we also seen how to deal with Android UI Automator. Okay, so this test is done using Android UI Automator. And the syntax is attribute, open brackets, place the value. That's it. So that's pretty much about Android UI Automator. And again, one more thing. Now, if you carefully observe this, you can also validate checkable, check, clickable, enable. You know, these all are specific to object. Okay, these are not object identifiers, but still, you know, these are the features which that object supports. Like it can be clickable, no, it's false. It can be enabled, true, it can be focusable. So even these you can validate with the help of Android UI Automator, but not with XPath and IDs. And that's the beauty you have with this Android UI Automator. Okay, so you can even validate, clickable, checked, all this. Now, for example, in my test, so most probably you won't require this, but still I'm telling you for knowledge purpose. When you on this page, okay, you are already in this page now. Yeah, you see animation, autocomplete. So all you have all these, right? When you click on views, clickable is false. If you go and checking all this, clickable is everything is false. So if you have any test case in your test saying, make sure all these are not clickable. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12. There are total 12 options, 11 options, 11 indexes, right? There are total 11 options available, and all the 11 options should not be clickable. That is your test case. Yeah, that could be probably. And how do you validate that? When you have a scenario like validate clickable future for all options. If you get this kind of requirement, the only option left for you to go through this clickable property. These are properties basically for this specific object. And when clickable is false, that means it's not clickable. So with Android UI Automator, you can actually check that. Let's see how. I'll copy paste the step which I have taken in my previous class. Yeah, this is the step. Let me explain you. This, you know, we are just identifying the multiple elements with Android UI Automator, plural, because I want to get all the results which are clickable. Okay. And then you see inside this, you know, okay, this is just like attribute value, but unfortunately it's a property, not an attribute. Okay. So if you go back to your UI Automator, these are the attributes. Okay, these are the properties which support that object. Okay, so when you go back, this is till here you are familiar, but this is property, right? When there is a property and if you want to check that, you cannot just check like attribute. You need to write this step before that. New UI selector dot. Okay, this is Appium and Android internal logic. Okay, so they have all these properties defined in this class. So you need to concatenate new UI selector dot and provide your property. And this syntax is, I can show you here, / dot property value. And this is the syntax. Okay, please remember these two syntaxes. When you want to identify with an attribute, this is the syntax. And when you want to identify using property and you need to concatenate with new UI selector. Now, here I am saying, go and find all the elements, okay, which have clickable property as the true. How many we have? We don't have any. All these are false, right? And when I get the size of this, that should be zero. Okay, so to get the size of all the elements, simple. You say dot and you have size. Okay, so in the earlier lecture, from the list of the results, if you want to pull out one specific index, then command is get. Okay, from elements, if you want to pull out some special one specific index out of these results, get of first index. But here, I don't want to pull the results, but I want to know total result size, how many it has written. For that command is dot size. Okay, these are the two only we will be using most frequently. And I'll print this in my output. System.outprinter. This looks like little confused or little weird, but trust me, this is the only lecture. There are only few lectures in Appium which looks little bit tricky, and this is one of it. That's it. You will not see any difficulty more than this. Of course, this is not at all difficulty, but you need to remember some new things. Okay, and you will not find all this in Selenium web browser as well. Okay, so new selector clickable size, this should return as 0 because there is no property with a clickable true as per my clickable. Yeah, everything is false, right? Let's run the test. Make sure Appium server is down. Okay. No, it's not still down, I guess. Okay, perfect. No cleaning. So when it got hanged with 200, that means server is still on that old test. It's hanging there. I don't know why. So I need to do control C all the time so that it comes out of that execution and we can run it again. Earlier versions it used to come out, but in the latest version again it went for toss. But that's okay. That doesn't interrupt our testing. Maybe by the time you are doing checking that, it might be coming out. Okay, so what else? What is our output? 14. Clickable true. That sounds weird. So I clicked on views. Take a screenshot. That should not be 14, right? Control C, come out. Yeah. Okay, so let's see why it was 14. There are 14 clickable items. What we selected? Views. And here, let me take a screenshot again. It's clearly false, but when I am asking give me true, it's reading everything. So that's completely weird, and I'm sorry with the latest Appium version. I have dealt with a lot of examples of this in the previous Appium versions, but this is the latest what I am doing on, and I need to report the bug to them. That's the only option I have, but that's fine. Just keep remember how to identify the attributes. And I'm really, really not sure of why it's giving. Okay, let me go to the Appium official logs and show you how it works. Okay. Yep. You see here, this is the syntax. Okay, I'm directly doing dot size at this point. Okay. So this is the correct syntax we are using. That's what provided in Appium official logs. But that's something error. Fine, let's see that later. Probably if there is any new version and a fix, I'll let you guys know. But this is how you can identify the properties. Okay, so that's pretty much about Android UI automators, XPaths, IDs and class name. So what Appium suggesting us is, go back. So these are the valid locator strategies and we have seen all of those. Okay. Appium told us these are the location strategies you can use to identify elements, and I have explained you everything. XPath, ID, class and Android UI Automator, right? So that's the pretty much about these lectures, and in the next lecture, let's start with some gestures. Remember, till now, we did not do any Android gestures like swiping, scrolling, zooming, tap. So these are some specific gestures we have, right, for mobiles. We have not dealt all those till now. Okay. In the next lecture, let's start with core Appium gestures. And that will be really interesting to learn and understand. Okay. Thank you.